Good morning, everybody. Today is Sunday, November 1st. And if you've been following Jim Palantine at all on TMC, then you know that today is the New York City Marathon, and it's a very exciting day for him because he's been training for this for quite a while now. So I was on his blog last night, just looking back through his training. And I think his posts began sometime in June. And I noticed that as soon as he found out that he had gotten into the marathon, he had taken this challenge on head on. So he's been very diligent about his training. I don't know if you remember in the beginning, he was talking about the distances he was running and his diet, how he really knew he had to change his diet to increase his performance. And he did that. He talked extensively about changes he was making in his diet, the things that he was giving up that were ultimately making him feel better. We saw him progress in his distances as well as in his times for running. So he was getting faster and running further. And he also never let setbacks get to him very much. So, for example, his old herniated disc problems, or even his foot. So he had a problem with inflammation in a ligament in his heel. And he immediately went to somebody who could help him out with that, and he took care of that right away. But he never let those things stop him from moving forward with this goal. And to me, that has been such an inspiration to be able to witness. So he's even gotten people on TMC to make sacrifices as well in honor of him for this race. And to me, that means that he's got a following right now. And I think what happens is when people find a cause that they believe in very much and have their sights set straight on that cause, on that goal, and want other people to believe it as well, or can get other people to believe it as well, then I think that is a really good definition of a leader. And I think Jim has been showing us some tremendous leadership qualities with his training, with his progress for today. So today is like the culmination of all of this, and it's a very exciting day. So I'm sitting in my car, and I am on my way to the train station, and I'm going to hop on a train and go to New York City, and I'm meeting up with Bill at the Met, and we are going to hopefully get to see Jim running either on First Avenue or down Fifth Avenue, hopefully. And I think we're going to get to meet up with him later on as well. So I'm going to try my best to have some footage or some pictures of Jim in the race. And anyway, here we go. Bill's talking to Jim on the phone. We're trying to figure out where he is so that we can catch a glimpse of him on First Avenue. Because everybody's going by right now. You can hear all the cheering in the background. It's really exciting.
Okay. Yeah, I know what they are. All right. Best of luck, Jim. Everybody says hi. Best of luck.
Hi, Jim.
And, hold on a minute.
Hi, Jim. How you doing? Good. How you holding up? Good. Good. Oh, it's really exciting. Exciting to be here. We can't wait to see you.
Go, Jim.
Uh-huh. Oh, cool. Yeah, okay, we'll see you soon.
Hey, everybody. How's it going? Bill's back here with me. We're on 1st and 85th Street on the corner in New York City, and we are going to be waiting here for Jim to show up. So Bill just talked to Jim on the phone, and he's in Brooklyn. Did you say he's in Brooklyn?
Yeah, Jim's in Brooklyn. He sounds great. He's running well. I can tell from his voice that he's running in his pace. So my main advice to him was just take it easy. Don't try to make it a race. Just run as a training run. it sounds like he's doing it. So we're on first and 85th, waiting for him to come by. He'll be here in about 20 minutes. And go Jim!
Yeah, go Jim! Woohoo! So exciting. You can hear all the people shouting and cheering. And there's tons of spectators and fans out here. Wow, look at all those runners! My gosh! There's thousands! They're so powerful too!
Yeah, we're still waiting for Jim. He's coming close. Trisha just messaged us that he's at miles 14 and he's coming up close. Jim put a lot into this effort and we're wishing him the best. He had a lot of support from a lot of people and we all love him and wish that he hits the finish line at good strength and we're hoping to see him soon, so we're praying we can get a shot of him going by. We'll see how...
We're going to one way or the other.
Yeah, we're going to get it one way or the other. We might have to hook him and pull him in, but we're going to get the shot, so we'll catch you guys a little later.
Okay, thanks, Bill. Is that good?
Yeah.
How you feeling?
Well, nice to meet you.
How do you feel?
Great. Awesome.
Awesome.
Just great. Couldn't be better.
Yo, we're so excited to see you. We didn't think we get to see you.
I know. This is great. You guys are firing me on.
Oh, I'm so happy.
Absolutely. Cool. Catch you later. Yeah, I feel great. I just kind of sprinted ahead. My brother-in-law is coming up, so he's going to join me. So I got 2 minutes.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
It's been a great experience.
You've been so inspiring for your whole training and everything. I mean, you just set that goal and you just went right to it. It's here today and you're running it.
I highly recommend it to anybody.
Really?
It's just been life transforming just to train for this thing. To have all you guys behind me is just makes it all that much better.
It's been so much fun to watch and to listen to your.
What a way to get to know some new people. Okay.
Hey,
so
we'll talk to you. Okay. That was awesome!
Can't beat that. What an inspiration, huh?
That was great.
Good guy.
For sure. Love seeing him.
He's going to make it. He looks great. He's running with his brother.
Mm-hmm. We should go try to see him.
Yeah, we're going to try to catch him on the other side on 5th.
Okay.
See you guys later.